On Ringside tonight, we break new ground, the Daily Star Golden Gloves Tournament. We feature some of the best young boxers from England, Ireland, Scotland and Wales in a round-robin tournament. They've only got 6 minutes, so they go at it from the bell, hammer and tongs. It's exciting stuff. There's all the winners. If you tune in, you'll see all of the bouts. Now, Orlando Canizales, one of the longest-serving world champions, we see him defend against Derek Whiteboy from South Africa. That's his 12th defence. And we'll hear later, too, from Riddick, Big Daddy Bo. Yes, you're watching Ringside on Sky Sports, which, as you saw, contains something of a first tonight by featuring that Daily Star Golden Gloves amateur boxing tournament. That coming up in a moment, but first, some of the news which has happened over the weekend. Firstly, Nigel Benn successfully defended his WBC super middleweight title with a fourth round stoppage over the game but outclassed Lou Gent. Any questions over Nigel's ability, his chin and his punching power at this weight were hastily answered. He can now, of course, look forward, it appears, to a £1 million showdown with arch enemy Chris Eubank. So don't book your holidays in October. Former world heavyweight champion Evander Holyfield made his comeback on Saturday night and pounded out a convincing, if somewhat boring, unanimous points victory over Alex Stewart. We'll have more on that fight later in the show, and we'll hear from the man himself, his new trainer, and Alex Stewart. On the undercard, former world welterweight champion Lloyd Hannigan was stopped in the 10th in his light middleweight contest against the amazing Vinnie Pazienza, trying, of course, to regain a world title after having broken his neck in a car crash. Difficult to see where Lloyd can go from here, but of course domestically he is still one of the best around. Tuesday night in London, Francis Ampofo beat Albert Musankabala to lift the Commonwealth flyweight title and add that to his British championship. He now looks forward to an August meeting against Salvatore Fani in a challenge for the vacant European title. We wish him all the best for that. And lastly, former WBO heavyweight champion Ray Mercer was arrested and charged this week with attempting to bribe Jesse Ferguson during their fight. Mercer was losing to Ferguson and losing out on a prospective payday against Riddick Bowe. It is alleged Mercer offered Ferguson $100,000 to take a dive. And lastly, for those of you that care, Roberto Duran had a 10-round decision over Jacques Leblanc in Missouri. That fight at super middleweight. Duran now 89-9 as a pro and still hoping to become the first Latin to hold 5 titles. We'll see about that. Now, if you're watching last week, you'll know we held a competition to win tickets to the new stage play Ali, which opened in London recently. The question was, what was Ali's famous nickname? The answer, the Louisville Lip, not Cassius Clay, as some of you wrote in, and not the greatest. So the winners, Bob McGuigan from Watford, Mr. A. Reed from Billericay and Andrew Young from Dunstable. Tickets will be in the post tomorrow, so if you winners keep Saturday the 10th of July free, because that is when you're going. And so to tonight's action, you're going to see now some of the best amateur schoolboy boxers around. The Daily Star holds an annual tournament held in conjunction with either England, Scotland, Ireland or Wales's governing body. This year it was Scotland's turn to host the Golden Gloves. This is a great opportunity for you to take a look at the best 14, 15 and 16 year old talent around and make up your minds as to whether they are the stars of the future. This was a scene at the Time Capsule Leisure Complex at Cope Bridge, just a few miles from Glasgow, the venue for the 1993 Daily Star Golden Gloves Tournament. This is what each boxer was fighting for, his very own Golden Glove. The tournament is for young amateur boxers born in either 1977 or 1978 and from the four nations of England, Wales, Scotland and, of course, Ireland. It's a kind of a round-robin event with 6 weight categories for each age group, the weights ranging from 48 kilograms to 67 kilograms, and you are about to see the finals. It was a well-supported event, the crowd and the celebrities amongst them, including Walter McGowan, Charlie Magri, Ken Buchanan, Colin McMillan, Drew Doherty, and Gary Jacobs. As is usual now, the new but somewhat controversial scoring device was present, the ringside judges registering the scoring punches landed and the computer declaring the winner. The first final of the night was for boxers born in 1978 and in the 48 kilogram category, and it pitted Michael Andrews of Ireland, nicknamed Hitman, against Ross Wilson from Scotland, the current Scottish champion. Here's your commentator, Ian Dark.
Thank you, Gary. Two 14-year-old boys here dreaming that this is another step on the ladder to stardom. On the right of your picture in the blue, that's Ross Wilson from the Rosyth Amateur Boxing Club. And in the red of Ireland, on this occasion, Michael Andrews from the St Aidan's Club in Wexford. Good right hand already from Andrews, who calls himself the Hitman. They love their nicknames, even the young boy amateur star, especially in Ireland, apparently, where they've all got nicknames like Destroyer and Hitman and what have you. Very aggressive start here from Andrews in the opening round, and Wilson already in a bit of bother. Good stiff jab as well, Andrews finding. He's found the range straight away. The Irish have a very strong contingent here. Another right hand, two of them going thudding through again then from Andrews, and a standing count being delivered here to Ross Wilson. Just getting some time to clear his head. He'd been under pretty heavy fire from the word go. And Andrews still letting go with those right hands. And another standing count, the second. Torrid opening round for young Ross Wilson. Seems to carry a fair bit of power, young Andrews. And the referee has seen enough of it. And Andrews wins in the very first round. That was an impressive display of combination punching from him. He was particularly dangerous with the right hand, and poor Ross Wilson here from Cowdenbeath could never really get into the contest. Andrews was so aggressive, throwing so much leather, not connecting with all of it, but that right hand there threw to the head a very good punch.
Ladies and gentlemen, the referee has stopped the contest in favour of Andrews in the red corner.
And now you know why he calls himself the Hitman at the age of 14.
Please, your appreciation for a very sporting loser, an unfortunate lad there, Ross Wilson. Thank you.
Well, Michael Andrews taking his record to 44 wins in 48 contests.
In Scotland, Ross Wilson.
Ross Wilson coming up to collect his medal from Paul Weir, the WBO strawweight champion.
And the winner of the Golden Gloves, Ireland's Michael Andrews.
Andrews, the three times Irish champion, and he looks quite a prospect, doesn't he? A first round stoppage victory for him in the Daily Star Golden Gloves.
Second final of the evening was in the 51 kilogram category and featured Richard Hoare of Ireland from the County Wexford Amateur Club and Ned Lee from England from the very famous Repton. Here's round three.
And last round.
Ned Lee, the 14-year-old southpaw, tall and rangy in the blue here, and Hoare in red. Lee's been on top for the most part so far. It's England against Ireland here. Lee, who's won all nine bouts last year, and this year he has a record of winning six and losing two. Good stylist. Very impressive behind that southpaw jab he's been. Hoare trying to rough him up as they work in close, but Hoare's problem throughout here has been getting behind that raking jab. Bit of blood around the mouth of Ned Lee. And I think they just might have to wipe some of that away. A nasty cut on the inside of the mouth by the look of it. He's all right to continue though. It's in the 8-stone category at 51 kilograms. And Hoare doing well there, getting through with the right hand, the 14-year-old Irish boy. Very difficult fellow to fight, this Ned Lee. Throwing the punches from a long way back.
Hey.
2-minute rounds, of course, in these boys' amateur contests. Lee appears to be in control of this horn, needs to do something quite spectacular in these closing seconds. Good combination from the youngster from London again. There goes the final bell to end it. And Ned Lee, who's only lost 2 of 35 contests in his entire amateur career, looks to have notched up another victory there. Another lad who's dreaming of stardom and maybe going to the Olympic Games one day. Let's get the decision now from our MC.
Ladies and gentlemen, the points decision, that the winner is Lee in the blue corner.
Ned Lee, and look what it means to him to be the Daily Star Golden Gloves champion, Ned Lee, and he looked very, very stylish in doing it.
Very good loser indeed, Richard Hoare.
It was a 14-7 victory on the computer for Ned Lee over Richard Hoare. And the presentation being made by Jim MacDonald.
Richard Hoare of Ireland.
Jim, who was always such a dedicated pro,
of, champion,
do well to follow him.
England, Ned Lee.
And Ned Lee, who's looked one of the brightest young talents around at schoolboy level. He's only 14.
Now for the final in the 54-kilogram category. Bobby Beck against Derek Sheridan. England against Ireland again. Bobby Beck from Chatham, Derek Sheridan from St. Anne's Westport Amateur Club. Here's round three.
Final round then, Bobby Beck in the red here. The southpaw leading with the right hand. Sheridan, who calls himself Lights Out after James Tony. Good explosive exchanges between the two of them in this final round. They're really letting the leather fly. Crowd on their feet at the entertainment being offered up in this one. Beck, who comes from Chatham, which is the same base as Johnny Armour, our Commonwealth bantamweight champion. Sheridan there. Sheridan, who's won 39 out of 49 in his career so far. He's won an Irish title. And Bobby Beck with a 100% record this season. He's won all nine. And he's boxing quite neatly again here too. Hard to pin down behind that right lead of his. And just catching Sheridan with the right cross. Beck, also this year's schoolboy champion. And there goes the bell to end it. That round quietened down a good deal. Which of them will be collecting the top medal from Charlie Magri, the former world flyweight champion here? We'll find out in just a moment. Here's the decision coming up now from MC Mick Goodall.
Ladies and gentlemen, the winner of that bout on points, Beck in the red corner.
Bobby Beck keeps that 100% record. 10 wins this season and his overall career record going up to 33 wins out of 36.
I'm sure you'd like to show your appreciation for a very good loser indeed. They have Derek Sheridan.
Victory there for England over Ireland.
The points awarded for that were 11-5.
That's on the computer punch-out, the new rather contentious system used in amateur boxing these days.
The runner-up Representing Ireland, Derek Sheridan.
Charlie Magri, the former world flyweight champion, still a very popular figure then, giving Sheridan his runners-up medal.
Golden Glove in the 54-kilogram category, representing England, Bobby Beck.
Another southpaw wins.
We're going to take a short break now. Join us for more from the Daily Star Golden Gloves in a moment. Welcome back. Fourth bout of the evening. John McCready from Scotland, the local boy, against Mark Heaney from Ireland. McCready from Cope Bridge. Once again, here's Ian Dark.
Third round coming up here then. John McCready, the 15-year-old Scottish lad in the red vest here, and Mark Heaney, who's 14 from Ireland, in the blue. It's been pretty even, this one, so far, and it could depend on this last round. McCready with a good record of 17 wins and 2 defeats in his career so far, the lad who represents the Four Isles Amateur Boxing Club in Airdrie. Nice right hand from McCready getting through there. Little warning for Heaney. Heaney, 4 times the Irish champion and 4 times the Ulster champion as well. And I think his head guard may just have come a little bit loose. Yes, indeed, the strap being tightened there in the corner for Mark Heaney. And he looks a pretty stocky, tough character. This is the 9 stone category, or 57 kilograms. In pro boxing, they'd be featherweights. Still having a bit of trouble with that head guard of his, I think, Heaney. But he's working quite well now. Stocky little southpaw. Definite reach advantage for McCready. Worked well there and got him with a kind of right hook, come uppercut. That looked a good punch. Corner just being told to keep quiet, the McCready corner. Not scoring blows those from McCready. The whites on the gloves to help the judges identify whether the punch has been landed with the correct part of the glove. And it was certainly there by Heaney. And again, the Irish boy just doing the sharper work maybe in this final round. There goes the bell to end it, and a nice display of mutual respect between the two of them. It was a good contest, a close-ish one as well. Heaney, for my money, just got the best of that last round of the bout. But we'll find out what the judges made of it in just a second. Heaney looking to add to those 8 championships he's won already. Here he comes now.
Ladies and gentlemen, the points decision, the winner, Heaney in the blue corner.
Well, Mark Heaney's got it. He is the Daily Star Golden Gloves champion for 1993. Big moment for him and for Ireland.
I'd like to show your appreciation for a very, very good loser indeed there, please, for John McCready.
Presentation will be made by Walter McGowan, the former world flyweight champion from Scotland. Representing Scotland, he's not a flyweight now. John McCready, the runner-up. His sister Bernadette is a Scottish international netball player.
And the winner of the 57-kilogram class, representing Ireland, Mark Heaney.
Mark Heaney, who likes to call himself the Destroyer.
Now to the 60-kilogram category, Teddy Day. His ambition is to fight in the Olympics against Patrick Mobey from Belfast and the very famous Dockers Amateur Club. We're going to join this one in round 2.
Second round, Teddy Day in the red, the Londoner. And in the blue, it's Patrick Mobey, the 15-year-old from Belfast. very, very tall indeed. Up at around 9 stone 9 or 60 kilograms this. Mowbray with height and reach advantages, big ones here over Day. Day was the schoolboy champion this year and was a finalist in 1991 as well. Like nearly all these boys, this is ambition as being to compete in the Olympic Games and the Commonwealth Games as well. And it may not be too far away for some of them, maybe only a couple of years. This is nice boxing, though, I must say, by Mowbray. Counter-punching well off the ropes, using his jab well. And somehow, Day has got to get to work inside. Exactly the right tactics from Mowbray, moving and jabbing, and trying to keep Day off balance, never letting him get set. These days in amateur boxing, the scoring is done entirely on punches landed as the judges hit their buttons and put their scores into the computer. In former days, style counted for quite a lot more, and there's a lot of style in that round, I must say, by Mowbray. Thoroughly enjoying the evening here. Patrick Mowbray then from the Dockers Club in Belfast. 31 wins out of 36 so far, twice the Irish champion, 3 times Ulster champion, 4 times the County Antrim champion, and 4 times the Northern Boys Club champion. He's had a bit of a star-spangled career already. Final round then, 2 minutes remaining in this one, in the 60 kilogram class. Just to remind you, Mowbray in the blue, Day in red. Still good jabbing from Mowbray. Day is finding it very difficult indeed to get in range. Same pattern, good lateral movement, jab and move, hit and run style from Patrick Mowbray. What can Day do about it? Time is running out. Well, to be honest here, young Teddy Day is getting outboxed here by the Irish boy. Now that's what he wants. He wants a close quarter brawl rather than this business of Mowbray just keeping him on the end of that jab all evening. Well, I must say, just scoring this myself, I've got Mowbray in a big lead here. He's done this very impressively, and he looks very good indeed for a 15-year-old. Mowbray holds his hands aloft. I think he knows he's won it. And Day not going into any phony celebrations of his own. Some of the action again. You can see how nifty the footwork of Mowbray is, quite apart from his physical advantages of the height and reach, which he used well throughout the 3 rounds there. Good strategy.
Ladies and gentlemen, a points decision. The winner, Mowbray in the blue corner.
Patrick Mowbray is the 60 kilogram champion, the 15-year-old, and He looked very, very good doing it too.
A very, very sporty loser, Tenny Day. Points awarded, 8 points to 5.
8 points to 5 it was. Well, I thought it was a little bit more emphatic than that, but they certainly had the right winner. Drew Doherty,
representing England,
British champion,
Tenny Day,
making the presentations here.
And the winner of the Golden Glove in the 60 kilogram category, representing Ireland, Patrick Mowbray.
Well, he'll need a bank vault soon to keep all his medals, this young man, the way he's going. Smile, please. You're a champion. They'll get used to it. Now, enjoying the star treatment. And there are one or two celebrities sprinkled around the hall enjoying this fine evening of amateur boxing. One of them, Gary Jacobs, talking to Gary Norman.
Gary Jacobs, European welterweight champion. It's good of you to come and give your support. There's a lot of people here for this event, isn't there?
It's fantastic. It's good for Scotland that a national title like the Golden Gloves can be held here. So it's fantastic for the locals.
Now, how many amateur fights did you have? Remind me.
Oh, I only had 12. I never got this far. I never even got like a Western Districts title.
But it's good for kids of this age to have this kind of background to bring them through to professional ranks.
Yeah, you have to start somewhere, and I mean, I think it's a very good thing. It's good for like a national title. I think it's 15 years old, 15 and 16 year olds. So at the end of the day, they're on that verge of like becoming like adults, and they go into the seniors after being 16 in the amateur ranks.
Just going back to you for a second, we're going to see you defend a European title soon.
Oh yeah, I mean, I'm scheduled to defend the European title in Glasgow in September. So I'm sort of semi on holiday. I'll start training for that the beginning of July and give myself 11 weeks for it.
Well, it is the off season, we'll give you that. What about a world championship?
Well, that's what I'm really praying and hoping for. It's going to happen maybe over the summer, but you have to stay busy, you have to defend what you have, and at the moment I have the European title, and to get into the position of fighting for the world title, I have to defend that and defend it successfully, and then I will fight for the world title.
Well, we look forward to that. Have you seen any future world champions here today?
Well, there's a few budding prospects, so but there's a long way to go for them.
All right, I'll let you get back and give them your support. Thanks.
All right, thank you.
Well, the sixth bout of the evening pitted John Cole against Bernard Corley. Corley calls himself the Terminator. Cole, once again, from the Repton Club. We're going to join this one, round three.
The tall John Cole in the red hair, Bernard Corley from Ireland in the blue. Cole's looked quite good so far. His hand speed has taken the eye. Corley's defence has been quite tight, quite compact. Nice right hand there. Cole seems to have a nice, liquid, languid style about him when he slips into gear. Cole with 24 wins out of 33. In his amateur career to date, and just one loss out of 5 this year. He's the one in red, remember, the English boy from the Repton Club. Nice combination again, and there's that hand speed I was talking about. Unnatural number of southpaws we seem to have on view here this evening, and they're doing pretty well too. Better work again there on the counter, I thought, from Cole. Oh, but here comes Corley letting go with some very good hooks. This is a good burst from the Irishman who calls himself the Terminator. And Cole was certainly hurt by some of those, and there's a little blotch of blood on his cheek as well. Corley really coming on strong there. Corley looking to turn this thing around in the third round. Cole had been on top to that point, or so it would seem anyway. But I think he was certainly shaken up by that burst from Bernard Corley. There's the bell to end it. Did Corley do enough? Cole came through it, but it was a very strong last minute or so of the contest from Bernard Corley, the one-time Irish champion. Now action again. Now look at him letting go with those hooks. Not all of them landed, but a fair few didn't. There was a particularly good left hook. Earlier on, though, Cole looked the superior technician of the two.
Ladies and gentlemen, the winner on points, Cole in the red corner.
John Cole wins at 63.5 kilograms, that's around 10 stone, gets that decision.
Ladies and gentlemen,
despite Cawley's strong finish.
Very, very good loser, Bernard Cawley.
Be interesting to see how close they scored that.
The points awarded for that, 15-9.
Well, there's the answer for you, 15-9 in favour of Cole from the Repton Club and Colin McMillan, the former world featherweight champion, to make the presentations here.
Bernard Cawley.
Cawley did well in that last round.
And the Golden Glove winner in the 67 kilogram class, representing England, John Cole.
John Cole, who's been boxing since he was 9 years old, and he is the 1993 Golden Gloves champion.
We're going to take a short break. When you rejoin us, we'll hear from one of the greatest ever of Scottish boxers, Ken Buchanan.
Coming up from the Golden Gloves here at Coatbridge, but let's meet one of Scotland's great boxing heroes now, Ken Buchanan, who's with Gary.
Well, Ken Buchanan, world lightweight champion 20 years or so ago. It's good of you to come and give your support. We're seeing some good boxing, aren't we?
Yeah, very good. The young boys, like, you know, they're showing, you know, a lot of potential there. They've
only got 6 minutes. They go hammer and tongs from the word go, don't they?
Oh, you bet. I mean, they've trained so hard for it, like, you know, and this has been the final night, like, you know, they're putting everything they've got into it and calling up in as much experience as they possibly got.
You did it all in your time. How important is it for these kids to have events like this to bring them through?
Oh, this is tremendous. I think it's fabulous for Coatbridge to be getting there, like, you know, because you've got to remember, the first professional show that was ever held was held in Coatbridge way back many, many years ago, like, you know, and Coatbridge has always been a good boxing centre. And I think tonight's just when I think it's fabulous for the police.
Do you support sort of professional boxing to some extent? We never see you in London at any of the big fights. Do you leave it alone now?
I don't get so much involved in it, like, you know, but I'm starting to get more involved now, like, you know, because I feel that for what I've done in boxing, where I've been and all over the world, like, you know, I have something to contribute to the boxing. And I'm through Frank Hendry and some of the other officials, I'm going to get myself involved with the boxing more so.
Try and train amateurs.
Yeah, amateurs and even professionals. I'm going to, you know, give some of the experience that I've learned over the years, like, you know, and fight in faraway countries that I've boxed in.
It's great that you're doing that because I think the game, especially the amateur game, needs more people like you who've done it all to lend their support, because the amateur game is suffering, I think.
Oh, very much so. Like, you know, there are a lot of good shows that are coming off in Scotland, like, you know, in Britain, but I still feel that there's need for more trainers, more men. And I'm looking myself personally to get a position with the Scottish Amateur Boxing Association. It would allow me to travel through the East and so forth and go to the clubs and not stand on anybody's toes like the trainers now, but to help them and guide them and maybe show the boys one or two things that they're not doing that they should be doing, like, you know, just to make them a wee bit better.
Maybe our Olympic record might get better over the years. It's been a long time since we won a gold in the Olympics.
Well, the only man I can think of is Dick McTaggart, like, you know. And he won the Val Barker Trophy as the most stylish boxer. And to me, he was the best amateur boxer I've ever seen in my life. We've got a lot of good amateur boxers, but I think what happens to amateur boxers is the keenness is not all there when they go to the gym at times. And when they get a wee bit older and they can go out with a few girls, have a few drinks and that, go out with their pals and that, the same keenness seems to drag away, fall away, because of the fact that maybe they're not getting the right man behind them to push them, like, you know. And I feel I've got that authority.
Well, I wish you every success for that, and I'll let you get back to enjoy the boxing. Thanks, Ken.
Thanks very much.
Good to see Ken Buchanan giving his support to this local event. Very important to the town of Coatbridge. Now, the first final in the boxers born in 1977 category at 51 kilograms. Wayne Breen of Ireland and Damien Dunyan of Wales. We're going to join this one in the first round. Once again, Ian Dark.
Wayne Breen in red here, Dunyan, the Welsh boy, in the blue. Dunyan with a very good reputation as well. Born in Manchester, but the family settled in Newport, South Wales, some time ago. Two Welsh schools titles to his name already. Dunyan. Breen comes from St Patrick's in County Wexford and has lost only 9 of 68 contests so far. Good record. Good aggressive burst there from Dunyan, letting go the left hook. Breen didn't look too happy that the standing count was administered, but I don't think the referee there, Glenn Bell, had too much choice. So a standing count already for Wayne Breen. Again, Dunyan looking dangerous with that right hand of his. Hand speed looks good too. Defense compact. As Ken Buchanan was saying to Gary just a moment or two ago, these boys train so hard, and often it's a case of them coming home from school and then having to do their homework and getting down the gym, getting all their sparring and other training done. So hats off to them, and let's hope that kind of dedication pays off for them. As Ken was saying, we certainly could do with some big amateur stars coming through. No Olympic gold since Chris Finnegan in 1968. It's too long. Dunyan certainly looks the part here. Good opening round for him. Dunyan, 16 years of age, and there's Breen in the other corner breathing hard. He had to take some good punches in that round from Dunyan, who was aggressive and fast. Right hand there sending him reeling back into the ropes. That was where the standing count was administered. So second round, Dunyan a top Welsh hope. 2 minute rounds, remember, so only 6 minutes in all for them to make their impression on the judges. Thoroughly enjoyable night of boxing, and I notice in the programme, good to see that messages of support for the boys passed on from the likes of Don King, Mike Tyson, Julio Cesar Chavez, Michael Nunn, and Roy Jones Jr., the new IBF middleweight champion. And that's the kind of thing that the families will appreciate as well. Dunyan again letting the punches fly. Dunyan in the blue, remember. And it's a tough one this so far for the Irish boy, Wayne Breen. He's won 5 area titles in Ireland and has been a national champion once too. But Dunyan is putting up one of the performances of the night so far. His footwork's good as well. Just look where Dunyan has his gloves, high held, protecting the head, and when he does come out from behind that shell, he throws the punches with good speed. And again, just picking some holes in the defense of Breen. And he's on top in a big way in this one, Damian Dunyan. How hard it is after 4 minutes for Wayne Breen. He took quite a few combination punches to the head from this insistent pressure of Dunyan. This is the second round. A couple of body shots from Dunyan, the right to the head, that looked to land with quite a bit of power, and the combinations that followed it too. This is the last round, and Dunyan must be in a pretty handy lead here. Dunyan in blue, Breen in red, 51 kilograms, it's around 8 stone. Bit of support around the hall for Damian Dunyan as well. Chance of Damian. He's boxed in the Gaelic Games as well, has a Welsh youth title to his name, and in this year, in fact, was the national schools champion. Very dedicated trainer. And has been offered a job down in Wales by a company called Stanco Systems, who support him well and have taken him on as a trainee carpenter. So he gets plenty of time for his training too, and he's right on top here. Did walk into a right hand there from Breen. In this final 2 minutes, really, Breen is going to have to go for it and just hope that he can find some jackpot punch to turn this around. Danyan has done a lot of good, solid work throughout the contest. Yet another southpaw, Danyan, you'll note. Breen's work just looks that more ragged in comparison, and he does leave himself opening to counter-punches. The bell goes, and surely Wales have a Golden Gloves champion in Damian Dunyan. That really was a very, very good performance indeed. Wayne Breen showed lots of guts, lots of courage, but Dunyan just had too much for him, quite honestly. And no matter how you score it, computers, notepads, even in your head, you'd have to make Dunyan the winner of that, and I think Breen probably knows it.
Ladies and gentlemen, the points decision, the winner, Dunyan in the blue corner.
Wales have a champion in the 51-kilogram class, Damian Dunyan. And it's an ever-growing list of titles for him.
Please, ladies and gentlemen, show your appreciation for a very good sporty loser indeed, please, for Wayne Breen from Ireland. The score's there, 16 points to 3.
And that just about reflects Dunyan's complete superiority over the 6 minutes there.
The runner-up representing Ireland, Wayne Breen.
The chairman of the British Olympic Association, Craig Reedy, making the presentations. First of all, to Wayne Breen.
The Golden Glove in the 51 kilogram category, representing Wales, Damian Dunyan.
Big applause for him, and Damian Dunyan keeps his 100% record when representing Wales. And there they are, just posing for the photographs, which will no doubt appear in the local papers around Glasgow tomorrow. It's good, too, that the boys get some publicity. And look at that magnificent trophy they get to take home with them.
Now, the eighth bout of the evening at the 54-kilogram class. This was going to prove to be a thriller. Gerard Murphy of Scotland, Eugene Lacumba, who's won 46 of 49. Murphy, unbeaten. Here's Ian Dark, round one.
Well, this promises to be one of the best bouts of the evening. Let's see if it is. 54 kilograms, that's around 8 stone 6, bantamweight for the pros. Murphy in red for Scotland, Lacumba in blue for Ireland. Murphy from the Barn Amateur Boxing Club in Coatbridge, so a lot of local support for him, the boy in the red vest. But as Gary was telling you, Lacumba has this impressive record of only 3 defeats so far in his 49 bouts. Stylish southpaw, yes, another one. Some lovely counter-punching there off the ropes from Lacumba. Murphy's 15 years old and Lacumba 16. Just a few months between them. And Murphy on the attack, and listen to the support he's got in the crowd. He goes to the Cardinal Newman High School at Bells Hill, and a lot of his mates will be in the crowd watching him here. Just a cautionary word from the referee. Back to action. The Lacumba very tall for the weight. Bell goes to end the first round. They touch gloves very sportingly. And boxing has a lot of detractors, you know, but amateur boxing, it really does teach the boys who enter into it a great deal of discipline. You won't find many lads who go into the gyms boxing in trouble on the streets. There's Gerard Murphy, and in the other corner, Lacumba. Start of the second round. Listen to the atmosphere in the hall. Murphy in red, Lacumba blue. And Murphy coming out very fast at the start of the round and looking to nail Lacumba, who has to take quite a few punches to the head there right at the start of the round. Well, Murphy was fired up. The adrenaline was rushing and he's still going for it. Terrific stuff. What can Lacumba come back with? I think he was just caught a bit cold there right at the start of the round. He was almost rushed by Murphy. The Irish coaches, though, are full of praise for this boy, Eugene Lacumba. And he scores himself there with the right, or did he? It might have been with the inside of the glove, to be honest with you. Oh, lovely left, and Murphy walked straight onto it. Now Lacumba has weathered that blitz and just beginning to come back, and I think one of those blows just may have strayed a little bit low from Murphy. Murphy just switching to southpaw for a moment there. A switch hitter at the age of 15. High quality bout, this one. And not too much in it, though. Murphy will have scored heavily right at the start of this round with that cluster of punches to the head that had Lacumba just a bit shaken for a moment or so. Murphy working away to the body and getting in with a decent looking right cross as well at the end of the rally. Watch the holding. Murphy says to Lacumba. Murphy's round. Well, he really did come up with a very, very special start to this second round, did Gerard Murphy here. Just watch the way he makes Lacumba back up. And then let's go with a whole cluster of punches to the head and body. Not all of them got through. Lacumba took it well and came back himself pretty well in that round. Final round coming up. Gerard Murphy, the Scottish champion for the last 3 years, and showing why here, up against this talented Irish boy, Eugene Lacumba. And again, Murphy looking to start fast. Lacumba was ready for him this time, though, and came back with some good headshots of his own. I mentioned Murphy being three-time Scottish champion. Lacumba's been 5 times Irish champion. And he's having a point deducted, Eugene Lacumba, for holding. He'd had a little caution in round two, and he's really dispirited about that. So that might count on the scorecards. Well, it will. Murphy, I would think, is ahead in the contest. these boys might have a bit of a future. Murphy won a Golden Gloves title last year, in fact, in the 48 kilogram class. And he's looking to become the first ever Scot to win consecutive Golden Gloves titles. He hasn't done it yet, though. Referee, incidentally, is Glenn Bell here, who made that deduction for Lacumba. And the word from Lacumba's corner is that he does have problems with the nose from a punch he took in that second round. They think it might be broken. So he's fighting with a handicap. And there's the bell to end what was a very, very good contest indeed. I think those two really do have the utmost respect for each other after that particular 6 minutes. That was one of the very best bouts we've seen on what's been a marvellous night of amateur boxing here. Just maybe we've seen one or two of tomorrow's champions. We're going to get the decision in just a moment.
Very, very good contest indeed. A nice round of applause for both boxers, please.
Crowd appreciating it. And look at that. The boys clapping the crowd too.
The winner on points, Murphy in the red corner.
Gerard Murphy is a Golden Gloves champion for the second year running for Scotland. A very popular winner. But Lacumba was top quality opposition. He can be proud of that. That was a very, very good win indeed. And Lacumba not losing too much in defeat either.
Your appreciations for a very fine loser indeed, Eugene Lacumba.
And a big moment coming up too for Gerard Murphy.
The points awarded there, 14 points to 5.
14 to 5 for Murphy. Well, it looked a bit closer. And I said a big moment, and a big moment for Murphy, because he will get his presentation from Ken Buchanan. First Lacumba.
And the winner and first boy to win a Golden Glove 2 years running from Scotland, Gerard Murphy.
Gerard Murphy goes up and dreams that one day he might make the kind of impression that Ken Buchanan, the former world lightweight champion, made in boxing. Buchanan, a great, great fighter, still much admired. Lost his title to Roberto Duran. And there's Lacumba, who's in tears after that defeat. Well, Ken Buchanan here, and another real Scottish hero, Dick McTaggart, the 1956 Olympic gold medalist, talking now to Gary Norman.
Dick McTaggart, you are a legend in amateur boxing. You did everything. Just remind me and the viewers of your amateur record.
The titles of one night.
How many fights and how many
defeats? 637, and I was robbed 24 times.
Robbed? Didn't lose fair and square?
No, I lost fair and square, yes.
You better than anybody know how important it is for kids like this to have an event like this and to come through and get some experience.
I'm one of the boys. We never had these championships in our time. I would have loved to win that, and the boys are doing very well tonight in every way.
Do you do anything for amateur boxing now, or are you removed from it?
No, I've retired again for don't know if I'll retire for good. I retired 3 years ago, and I'm enjoying my little rest now.
Do you think there's a cause for professionals and guys like yourself who've done it all to get involved more so, because amateur boxing is struggling a little bit at the moment?
And not every country is the same. They need the boys that's been in the boxing to coach the boys. There's no use getting somebody that's never boxed before that does know about the game.
And let's face it, the future of professional boxing is dependent upon events like this and the kids that we're seeing today.
Well, that's the future of professional champions nowadays, because they turn professional if they do any good, which is a good thing.
Anybody caught your arm? I know the last contest was a bit special.
Yeah, well, the Murphy boy is good. I thought it was an Irishman at first with a name like that.
I'll let you get back to it and enjoy it. Thanks for talking to us, Dick.
Thank you very much. Thank you. Bye-bye.
Well, bye-bye from Dick McTaggart for the moment. Bye-bye from us. We're going to take a break. Join us after the break for more from the Daily Star Golden Gloves. Welcome back to the Time Capsule in Cope Bridge, just outside Glasgow. The Daily Star Golden Gloves. Now for a final in the 57-kilogram category, Tony Robinson from Middlesbrough and Ian Hackett from Ireland, nicknamed Styles. We'll join this one with Ian Dark in round two.
Tony Robinson, who lives in Middlesbrough, in the red, representing England here. Ian Hackett in the blue, from Drogheda in County Louth. Robinson, tall, powerful. That's at 57 kilograms, around 9 stone. Height and reach advantages here for Robinson. Oh, and that's a good looking left hook, and down goes Hackett. And no count administered. Well, I must say, that is slightly mysterious. I don't believe that was a slip. So Hackett just might have got away with that. Did look like a legitimate knockdown. But the referee is closer than I am. Robinson, who boxes for the Wellington Amateur Boxing Club up in the northeast. And he won the National Association of Boys Clubs title this year. That's another prestigious award at this kind of level. Punching with the inside of the glove. Tony Robinson just getting a caution about that. Slapping, basically. To score, the punches must land with that white marked area, the knuckle part of the glove. That's a good jab from Robinson. It's the punch he'd do well to just rely on, really, as his staple diet, because he does have a massive advantage in reach. Hackett from the Holy Family Club. I think that was definitely Robinson's opening round, without any doubt. He's won 29 out of 44 contests. Now, let's have a look again at what happened with what I thought was a knockdown. Now, left hook, and down goes Hackett. No count. Oh, well. Third round. Robinson in red. Hackett in the blue. Robinson appearing to be in a points lead so far. Hackett with some work to do, perhaps. Hackett with 50 wins out of 53. That's some record he brings into this contest. Calls himself Styles, or that's what the other lads in the Irish team call him, and maybe here it's the style he's having a problem with, the style of Robinson. Good lateral movement from Hackett. Scores there with the jab, but gets caught with a left hook back from Robinson. Hackett, 3 times an Irish champion, 5 times an area champion. Bags of talent, but finding this difficult against this very strong-looking 16-year-old Tony Robinson. Robinson's lost just twice in 14 contests this year. That right hand, good shot. And there's going to be a standing count for that. Hackett is not happy about it, but then you wouldn't expect him to be, would you? That was a good decision by the referee this time. And Robinson here underlining his superiority. Scoring well with the jab as well. Again, ramrod jab from Robinson, and follows it up with a right hand punch. There's a confident swagger about his work now. Well, Ian Hackett never really got into that very seriously, or so it would appear, the Irish boy from County Louth. And Tony Robinson was very, very impressive. You can see why he won the boys' club title this year. There's that right hand that caused the referee to jump in and administer the standing count. Another lad from the northeast, Tony Robinson. Here's the decision.
Ladies and gentlemen, a points decision. The winner, Robinson, in the red corner.
Had to be, really. He wins. And it's a Golden Gloves championship for Middlesbrough.
Very good there for Ian Hackett of Ireland. The points awarded there, 11 points to 6.
11 to 6 in Robinson's favour on the computer. And Chris Pyatt, the WBO middleweight champion of the world, recently crowned to announce and award the medals and shields, first to Ian Hackett.
And the winner of the Golden Glove in the 57 kilograms category, representing England, Tony Robinson.
Well done, Tony Robinson. That was a good display from him. Chris Pyatt giving him his lovely trophy. Now, let's meet another of the celebrity boxers we have, Colin McMillan, the former world featherweight champion, with Gary.
Well, Colin McMillan, thanks for joining us. We've seen some great fights tonight, haven't we?
Yeah, it's been a very high standard. I think, you know, all the boxers that have come here, they've given it their all, and they've done themselves proud.
You found any prospects?
The one and two guys, they look very, very good. You know, it's a long way off yet, but they've showed a lot of form, a lot of promise.
Let's talk about you for a second. You've had the problems, well documented. How are you now since you've had the operation on the shoulder?
So still fine. I'm still working on it, you know, very much. Still going through a period where I'm trying to make it a lot stronger. Hopefully, I'm hoping to fight in July in a warm-up fight. In September, I should be fighting the winner of the Murphy-Robinson fight.
Are you sparring, or are you just sort of ticking over and keeping yourself fit?
I have sparred before. I've sparred, you know, a number of occasions. The shoulder, you know, feels really good. But I want to make sure that when I step back into the ring, it's going to be, you know, fully repaired.
Who have you got your eyes on in particular, apart from the winner of as you said, of Murphy and Davison?
Well, I think the featherweight division's opened up so much now. You've got Vargas come on the scene, but he should be fighting Kevin Kelly, and maybe the winner of that would be a nice fight.
What did you make of Vargas? He looked very, very special to me.
He looked a very, very good fighter, but it's so hard to, you know, make a judgment on one fight. I want to see him fight Kelly and see how that goes, and then I'll make another judgment.
Will you have any reservations when you step into the ring, or will it all, once you get that fight out of the way, then you'll be happy?
Well, obviously, first time back into the ring after such a long layoff with the shoulder, there's going to be a little bit of a psychological problem there. But I don't want to actually step into the ring until I'm, you know, sure that my shoulder will be fine. So when it is, you know, it should be okay.
Well, you're a smart and you're an intelligent boxer, so you know what you're doing, and we wish you all the best.
Lovely, thank you.
Well, 9 down, 3 to go, the 10th bout of the evening. Well, that pitted Joe Donkin of England, another boxer from the northeast, against Kevin Comiskey from Ireland, nicknamed Ripper. This in the 60 kilogram category. We're going to join it in round one with Ian Dark.
Joe Donkin in the red here, looking to win another Golden Gloves title for the northeast of England. Tony Robinson's already got one. Comiskey has the reputation of being a bit of a dangerous puncher, the 16-year-old Irish boy who calls himself the Ripper. And his right hand landing early as well. Donkin's won 11 out of 14 contests so far. He's been boxing for only 18 months. This is a big test for him. And already taking some fairly hefty looking blows to the head from Comiskey. Comiskey, the 3 times Irish champion. Now some good toe-to-toe exchanges already in this first round. Donkin's defence maybe just looking a shade open though. Comiskey almost lanky, isn't he? Very, very tall indeed. And that's going to be problems for Donkin. But arms like an octopus. And Donkin there walking into quite a few punches on the ropes and having to take a few, and now a standing 8 count for him. So problems in the first round for the English boy, Joe Donkin here. Kevin Kamieski in the blue with the green stripe of Ireland down his shorts on top early on. Oh, and that's a really big right hand and a left as well. And Donkin is in no sort of state at all. They're really sagging. I thought he was going to go down. He was hurt badly. That's his second standing eight count for Donkin. And he does well to fight on. No, he can't fight on. And I think that's a very sensible decision because he was quite groggy. Kamieski came with a reputation of being a hurtful puncher and showed exactly why there. And Joe Donkin has to be rescued in the first round. Now, let's look at this again. Kevin Kamieski, bang, right hand. Woo-hoo. And look at Donkin there. I think only the ropes kept him up.
Ladies and gentlemen, the referee has stopped the contest. The winner, Kamieski in the blue corner.
And that was lethal power from Kevin Kamieski.
And your appreciations, please, for a very sporting loser, Joe Donkin.
And look at that, he holds the ropes to let his opponent get out first. It's been a marvellous night of sportsmanship here in Coatbridge. Gary Jacobs, European welterweight champion, to make the presentations. Now, happily, Joe Donkin's all right again.
And the Golden Glove winner in the 60-kilogram category, representing Ireland, Kevin Kamieski.
And he can take that lovely trophy back to the Trim Club in County Meath. Kamieski is the champ.
We're going to take another break. Two more finals to go in the Daily Star Golden Gloves. Rejoin us in a moment. Welcome back to the Time Capsule in Coatbridge. Two more finals to go. Here's the first of them. In the 63.5 kilogram category, the two Roberts, Robert Bell, another boxer from the northeast of England, against Robert Weston from Wales, will join this one in round three.
Third round then, and Robert Bell in red from Sunderland. Weston, the Cardiff-born Welshman, boxes for the Highfields Amateur Boxing Club and has titles at Welsh senior schools and youth level already. Bell, the NABC champion this year, National Association of Boys Clubs. Just watch the use of the head there. Warning from the referee. Both these boys 16 years of age. Oh, made to miss embarrassingly there, Weston, and losing his balance. Wales already collecting one title with Damien Dunyon, who was so impressive. Can Weston add to that? As you can see, he's a very tall boy, but he's... Oh, that right hand was a crackerjack from Bell, right out of the blue, and he's hurt by that. Now, can Weston continue? He can't. Not fit to continue. They are very much on the side of caution. He thinks he's all right, but you've never met a boxer yet who says, yes, stop me, have you? And that's a sensible decision. These are, after all, only boys. And Robert Bell really did come up with the goods there. That right hand finished it in one. Let's take a look at this. Boom. And look, his legs there are doing a silly dance after that landed.
Ladies and gentlemen, the referee has stopped the contest. Bell in the red corner is the winner.
Well, Robert Bell producing the equaliser. And he is the Golden Gloves champion at 63.5 kilos, 10 stone. And that was one of the punches of the night. Barry McGuigan, the former world featherweight champion, and now, of course, leading the moves towards the excellent Boxers Union that started will make the presentations.
Robert Weston.
Well, he's all right again now, Robert Weston.
And the winner of the 63.5 kilogram...
Barry McGuigan saying, don't worry about it.
England, Robert Bell.
Robert Bell, then, will go home to Sunderland with that memorable trophy as Daily Star Golden Gloves champion. And the editor of the Daily Star, Brian Hitchin, now has a special award to make to Dick McTaggart, the former Scottish Olympic gold medalist. It's coming up in just a moment or two.
Thank you, ladies and gentlemen. Thank you very much indeed for being here tonight. Thank you for all the wonderful celebrities who have given their time to be here tonight, because we all appreciate it, and we have seen, as we all have over the years, some magnificent boxing. Here at the Golden Gloves tonight, the Daily Star salutes, for his services to amateur boxing, Dick McTaggart.
Wonder, of course, what would have happened had Dick McTaggart turned professional. Great servant to Scottish amateur boxing. Wonderful stylist.
Well, a well-deserved award there, and it leads us into our last fight. Dean Frost from England against Tommy Peoples from Ireland. Peoples, well, he calls himself the Tank. This, in the 67 kilogram category, it's round three.
This is the heaviest weight on view here, 67 kilos, around welterweight, 10.5 stone. And good punching there from Frost in the red, representing England. He comes from Lee Park, down near Portsmouth in Hampshire. Peoples, the Irish boy, being made to miss. This is a close fight, though, so far. Close contest. Tommy Peoples calls himself the Tank, trying to steamroller Frost. Just a little warning for Dean Frost. Frost has won 23 out of 37 so far. Peoples has two Irish championships to his name, the boy from Ramelton, County Donegal. That's some good work there from Frost. Just making Peoples miss and coming back with his own right hook. Now, that perhaps not one of the more exciting contests of the night, and not a great deal to choose between them, quite honestly, there. And it'll be down to the judges to sort that one out. Tommy Peoples, a 16-year-old Irish boy, Dean Frost, age 15. Who gets it?
A points win there, points decision in favour of Peoples in the blue corner.
Well, Tommy Peoples has an Irish victory to his name there.
For a very, very good loser, Dean Frost.
And Dean Frost.
The score's there, 9-8.
Well, it really was very, very close indeed, 9-8. But Peoples has the Golden Gloves trophy to take home to Ireland, and Dick McTaggart to make the presentation to him.
Representing England, Dean Frost.
Heartbreaking for him to lose so agonizingly as that, 9-8.
And the winner of the Golden Glove in the 67 kilogram category from Ireland, Tommy Peoples.
And well done to Tommy Peoples, Golden Gloves champion, to add to his two Irish titles and five Ulster championships too. And that the last contest of what really was a very, very good evening's boxing indeed. And I hope you enjoyed it as much as I certainly did watching the boys in action here at Coatbridge.
Well, the crowd enthralled all the way through those finals. As Ian said, he enjoyed himself. I certainly enjoyed myself, and I'll look forward to seeing it again next year. We'll leave you with a shot of all the winners from the night. Take a look. One or two of those you may be hearing a lot from in the very near future.
Well, I'm sure you'll agree, a vastly entertaining event with a couple of good prospects to look out for. I thoroughly enjoyed the night's entertainment, and I look forward to going next year when I believe it will be held in London. Well, from the amateurs, and who knows, maybe the professionals of the future, to the pros themselves.